Hi, I'm Miss Penny from South Florida PBS and the creator of all things KidVision. We're at a preschool today, and so you're going to hear people picking up their children because we're here at pickup time. We came today to find out about process art because that's what our presentation is called, Art from the Heart. Process art for very young children. And process art is about activating the creative mind. So today we're going to talk about what process art is, why we want to do process art in preschool, and how to do it. So first, let's talk about what process art is. Process art is just about the process of doing art. It has no beginning and no end. It's just about having the right materials out for children to explore and create and find out what things are all about. Let me give you an example. It's Valentine's Day. A piece of product art would be a teacher puts together an easel, and they have children easel paint until it's just enough paint, and they take the paper away, and then they cut out a heart, and they put it against pretty red and pink paper, and they put it up on the bulletin board, and it looks great. And the child doesn't even know if they did it, because as soon as they had enough paint on it, they took it off. Product art, that's product art. Process art is more where you set up the easel, a teacher sets up the easel, and then they just let the child paint and paint and paint until it turns brown. And during that time, the child's learned that if they put all the colors together, it turns brown. But it's not necessarily good for a bulletin board, but it's very good for their learning. But then there's art for learning. So if I wanted to teach kids that white and red make pink, and I'm doing a Valentine's Day activity, I might have at the easel just have white and red paint, and the children would learn that white and red make pink. So there's three types of art. There's process art, which is just about enjoying the art. There's product art, which is exactly what it says. It's about the product at the end. And there's art for learning, which is putting art together so that, like you're going to have a number book, you take markers and you put one stamp and you write the number one and they learn about the number one. And you might have a book, a counting book 1 through 10 that they've been involved in, but it's art for learning. So all three arts are good and all three arts should be used in the classroom, but process art is particularly important. There's so many things that kids learn from process art. They learn confidence, they learn creative thinking, problem solving, imagination, how materials interact with each other. They learn to think for themselves, make their own choices, explore ideas, test theories. They develop a sense of themselves because they're creating art for themselves, and they become innovators, and they learn to relax. They're just enjoying the art. So how do we set that up in the classroom so that children can have all those advantages? Let's talk about it. The first thing to get ready is child development. You need to know your children. Are they 1? Are they 2? Are they 3? Are they 4? Once you know your child, then you want to get activities ready that they can manipulate, that they're old enough to do. Your process art materials then become important because they're developmentally appropriate. And you want to give children time to interact with the materials. You don't want to just, they have 5 minutes in the art room and then they're done. You want to put the materials there and give them time to play. So let's talk about process art materials. There's 4 things that you need to make process art amazing. First, you need a base. A base would be like paper, clay, toilet paper rolls. It's the base of where the art starts. After you have your base, then you need connectors like glue, tape, pipe cleaners, something that connects the art to the paper. Then you need tools. You need a paintbrush. You might need a glue brush. You need tools. What are children going to use to put whatever they're going to put on the paper? For instance, glue, they need the glue bottle to make that happen. But the most important thing in process art are the treasures. The treasures are sequins and buttons and colorful pipe cleaners and yarn and pom-poms and all the wonderful things that children want to touch and be around, because that's what's going to spur their interest. So in your process art area, in your in your art room, you want to have developmentally appropriate materials. You already we talked about child development, so you want to have materials that are developmentally appropriate. And you want to use them in materials that children can use independently. For instance, the four-year-olds can use these independently. They can take the top off, they can put the top on, they can put them back, they can be independent with them. So you want to make sure that all the materials are independent. Like the three-year-olds are going to use these independently. And you want to change them periodically so that you have different materials available at different times so that children have different opportunities and allow time. Give them time to play. And the thing that we're all concerned about right now is interactions. So we want to make sure that the teacher is interacting with the child. Make sure that you have time, that you spend time in the art room with your kids. And you just sit with the kids, let them lead the conversation. Talk about the process that they're experiencing. Ask open-ended questions. For instance, we have zoo stickers and we say, have you ever been to the zoo? And let them talk about the zoo animals that they know while they're playing with the stickers in of zoo animals. So you want to ask questions and lead questions about what the children are exactly experiencing at this time. And you'll see as we play with ones, twos, threes, and fours, how I interact with the children is just talking about exactly what they're doing. So that's process art in a nutshell. It's easy, it's fun, it's interactive, and it's not about taking anything home. It's just about them learning, creating, touching, experiencing, and being okay with themselves because they haven't been said, okay, draw a picture of yourself, make sure you have arms and legs and eyes and ears and nose, and there's time for that. But there's also time to just enjoy the process of art. Preschool teachers, did you know you can earn 10 CEUs and 100 in-service hours for $40 per school year online? Join the KidVision Teachers Association at www.kidvisionprek.org. Two-year-olds love art. They're walking, they're talking, they're energetic. They like to put things together and take things apart. They like to name things. They know about their colors. They know about shapes. And they like to play. So let's play, do some process art with two-year-olds. I have the table ready. What we're going to use as our base is contact paper. What we're using as our tool is the child. The child is the tool that's going to take things off and put things back on. And what we're going to use for our treasures are pom-pom balls, pipe cleaners, feathers, and shapes. So let's get out our two-year-olds and see what they like to do during process art. Today we're going to play with contact paper. Can you feel the contact paper? What does it feel like? And we have contact paper and we have beautiful things to put on the contact paper. Oh, what is that? There you go. You could stand up and play too. We have pom-poms and look at these. Ooh. What is that? What colors are you taking out? Would you like one of these, Leo? Look how fun that is. Blue. What color is it? It's blue. And what color do you have? Do you have blue? Uh-oh, you're gonna get it? And look, we have feathers. Would you like a feather? You got it, good for you. Would you like a feather? What color? How does that feel? Is it soft? You can take more than one. Would you like to take some feathers? Wonderful, and look, we have some shapes. And this is what we're gonna do. Are you ready, Leo? Look, we're gonna stick it on and take it off. And then what is that? A circle. You have purple. Do you have a purple heart? Do you want to put it on the paper? Feel the paper. Oh, what do you have? Green. Here's another green one. Good job.
And
green. You can put them all over the paper. Would you like some more of these? You can reach over and grab them. Oh, is it sticky? It's sticky. Look at that. It's sticking.
On the table.
You can put it on the table. Wonderful. Look how many you have. Wow, did they stick?
Yeah.
Let me see. Try to pull it off. See if it, yes, they're sticky. Would you like some more? Are you gonna get, you want me to get that for you? Here you go. You're putting them on top of each other. Oh, you like those. Go ahead. It's sticking. Here, how about if I take this off? And you can choose what one you like. Oh, you want all of them. You like the green one. And the purple one. How about you, Leo? Oh, you like the purple one too. You're gonna put them on? You're sticking them on. That's great. This is very sticky. Do you want some more? Okay. What color are you choosing? Green. How about some shapes? Oh, our paper. I think we need to put this all over the paper. Look at all those shapes. What color is that one? It came to two. Very nice. What's that? It's so sticky. Here, I'll help you. Do you need help? I'll help you. There. You like these, don't you? Oh my goodness. The paper is so sticky. Look at that, when you have contact paper, it's sticky. They get very busy. Can you get it? Can you reach it? You got it, Leo, you got it. You're picking it up. Good job. It's so sticky and fun. Oh no, what happened? Oh, look at that, they went everywhere. You can take them on and off. Look at that. It's just so beautiful. What are you gonna do with those? What do you think? You're gonna stick them on? They look so nice. This is gonna be a beautiful piece of art. Does that stick on there, Leo? Does it stick on there? Is that sticky?
Sticky.
This will be sticky if you put it on the paper. Now it's sticky. We like, you want to put things back in?
What's that? Goodness.
What color is that? It's red. Good job. How many do we have? How many do you think there are? Which ones do you want? You want all the red ones or you don't? So many. My goodness. Where are you gonna put them? That's a good place. And put them right next to each other. Did you stick one down there? Do you want another shape?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll get you some shapes. What shapes do you like?
The little eyes you have been saying.
Okay, you're gonna find a blue one? Oh, that's a triangle. A triangle? Good talking. Do you want another triangle? What color is that one? It's a triangle. It's a blue triangle. You have two triangles. Do you want to put them together? Oh, you're going to give your friend a triangle. How nice. And she can stick it on there. Did it stick? And you can pull it on and off. And they're such good cleaners. Look at that. This is all part of the process. It's about having fun, enjoying themselves, and all the things that they're learning. They're learning to clean up. She's being so kind. And they're learning about putting away, and they're learning about sticking, and colors, and shapes, and sharing. So many wonderful things. Thank you so much for playing with me. Did you like it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Uh-oh. We have to be careful. What can happen with this? It can fall down. Okay. Are you going to put some more feathers? Okay. What about, where's she?
In here.
You're going to put it in here. There you go. You're going to put them away now? Your two-year-olds like to take them off and put them on. Good job. Look at that. Do you want to put some in or you want to take them out? You're going to put them in. He's going to take them off. Oh, you're sorting. They're sorting. Oh, here you go. Look at how nice that is. And that's process art for two-year-olds. Preschool teachers, did you know you can earn 10 CEUs and 100 in-service hours for $40 per school year online? Join the KidVision Teachers Association at www.kidvisionprek.org. Watch, learn, and play with KidVision today. If I didn't sit with them and know that they weren't being successful with the materials they had, I wouldn't know to keep moving and keep trying new things until we got it right. So we need all the things. Teachers need to be there. That's what children like the most, is your attention. So while they're doing process art, you're talking to them, you're interacting with them, and that's just as important as the materials that you have. But remember, for process art, you need four things. You need the base, which is the paper, the Play-Doh, the contact paper. That's the base of the art. You need connectors, like glue and tape and contact paper and things that are connect the thing, what you have, to the paper. Then you need tools, like a paintbrush or a dot marker, or things that children are going to use. So you need a tool, and then you need treasures, which are the most important thing, which are like sequins and colorful pom-poms and yarn to use and pipe cleaners with pretty colors. So remember those four things and set up your classroom appropriately so that in your art area, there's a chance for children to explore art on their own terms. And that's activating the creative mind. So thank you very much from KidVision. I'm Miss Penny, and this is called Art from the Heart, process art for very young children. Thank you.